Well, you've made it to Japan. You've picked up your bags and you're ready to go experience everything that Japan has to offer. The shopping, the food, the culture. But what's your plan for getting around? Well, if you're like 99.9% of travelers to Japan, you'll certainly be using the Japan Rail System. But if you've ever seen maps of Japan's rail system, this can look extremely intimidating. So today we're going to put your anxieties aside and show you how it's done. If you've done any research at all about Japan, you've probably heard of several different terms like Suica, Pasmo, and a Japan Rail Pass. But what do these mean? What do they cover? Well, by the time you're finished with this video, you'll be ready to travel Japan like a pro. In this video, we'll primarily be discussing the Suica and Pasmo IC card options, which are typically used for localized travel within the area you're visiting, but can be used everywhere in the country. The Japan Rail Pass, however, is your option for long-distance travel and is good for 1, 2, or 3 weeks, depending on your length of stay and your travel needs. This is completely different from the Pasmo or Suica IC cards, and I'll cover this in a separate video. So for now, let's just focus on your local travel, since that's what you'll likely be using first. But before we get started, I've got good news and bad news. First, the bad news. The bad news is that due to a post-coronavirus shortage of semiconductors, in July 2023, Japan indefinitely suspended the issuing of new Pasmo and Suica IC cards. But not to worry, there is a workaround for this. Both Pasmo and Suica are offering temporary 28-day IC cards. And yes, these are only valid for 28 days from the date of purchase. First, let's cover some basic information about IC cards. Each person will require their own separate IC card, and child cards are available for children up to 12 years of age with proof of age. Something to keep in mind though, these temporary cards are non-refundable, so just be aware of how much you put on each card. If you have a balance on the card when you leave Japan, you cannot get it refunded to you. Finally, one of the questions I get asked the most is, what's the difference between Pasmo or Suica? Okay, get your notepads out and get ready to take some notes here. Okay, are you ready? The difference between using the Pasmo and Suica is...
absolutely nothing.
That's right, there's no difference in what they do, what trains you can ride, or where you can use them. The only thing different about them is who provides them. Suica is provided by JR East, and Pasmo is from Tokyo Area Non-JR Train Companies. Again, they are completely interchangeable and can be used in the same way. Just if you buy your pass from a JR station, you'll probably buy a Welcome Suica card. And if you buy from a private line, you'll likely buy a Pasmo passport or similar card. That's all there is to it. So stop sweating which one to get, and just get it. Okay, so how do you buy your IC card? Well, if you decide on a Sanrio-style Pasmo, you can purchase it from the Pasmo desk located within the airport terminal. From here, you can conveniently purchase your Pasmo passport from one of the staff with a credit card only. The minimum purchase is 1,500 yen, and 500 of that is just for the purchase of the card. The remaining 1,000 yen or more will be your available balance. I recommend starting with at least 3,000 yen. You can always top it up later, and I'll show you how to do that in a moment. If you prefer a Welcome Suica IC, you'll go to the JR terminal in the airport. The Welcome Suica can be purchased with cash only from the ticketing machines. There is also no charge for this card, so 100% of your initial payment will be applied to your available balance. Using the machines is very easy. First, select your language. Then choose whether you want an adult or child card.
Please select the desired charge amount.
For this video, I chose 1,000 yen for example purposes only, because I already have my own card. But again, I recommend starting with at least 3,000 yen.
Please insert money for credit cards. Process.
And just like magic, the machine will issue you your new card and give you your change.
Thank you.
It's that easy. When you need to check or add funds to your balance, just go to any ticketing machine. And again, select your language, select charge or add value, insert your card. From here, we can see the 1,000 yen I just put on my card. I could also choose to add more funds from the options listed. If you're just checking your balance, select cancel and your card will be returned to you. Again, super easy. After you have your cards, and especially if you're traveling with kids, I find it easy to put each card in a retractable lanyard so everyone can easily carry and use their own card. Okay, let's head to the platform. Before you head to any train platform, you'll need to go through a gate and tap your card on an IC sensor. These gates may be marked or look slightly different, but any gate is fine. When you tap your card on the IC sensor, it'll beep and register where you entered so it can deduct the correct amount from your card when you get to your final stop or change train lines. If you ever have an issue where your card is not accepted or the gates just don't open, first, check the balance on your card at the readout on the gate. You can then go to any ticketing machine and add more funds or go to the train station attendant near the gate to resolve the issue. As far as navigating the train system, I actually recommend using Google Maps throughout Japan. Google Maps will tell you exactly what time your train departs and arrives, and which platform you need to be on. It's a very useful tool. If you happen to miss your train like I just did, just refresh Google Maps or re-input your destination information. Never worry, another train will be along shortly. Arriving train information is also displayed on the overhead arrival boards. But pay attention to which one you get on because some trains are rapid, meaning they bypass some stations, and others are local and they stop at every single station. A quick note about train etiquette. In Japan, it's considered extremely rude to speak loudly or talk on the phone while on the train. Please be respectful of the culture and avoid doing these things. If you have to change trains, Google Maps will again tell you which train line you need to use and which platform you need to go to. In this example, we can see that Google Maps is telling me that I need to transfer to the Keihin Tohoku line, which is a JR line, and catch the rapid train on platform 1 at 1:12 p.m. Just follow the signs and you'll be just fine. Ahead, we see the JR line and in smaller print, the Keihin Tohoku line. Just tap your card and go through the gate and keep following the signs. Another note on Japanese culture, when riding the escalator, Japanese will keep to one side to allow others in a hurry to easily get by. Which side of the escalator depends on what region of Japan you're in. Just follow what others are doing. Well, this is our connecting train. I think you've got the idea of how this works now. Just follow Google Maps, follow the signs, and if you're feeling friendly, don't be afraid to ask a local for help. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised with how willing they are to assist. You've got this. You're gonna do fine. Now just relax and go discover Japan. Welcome to Japan, guys. One final thing before we go. If you haven't already done so, please take a second to like this video and subscribe to join our family of the following recent subscribers. And we'll see you next time on Discovering Japan.